Is this simply a needed refreshing pullback in the stock market, or has Wall Street kind of run way ahead of the kind of plausible fundamentals for how well we're going to come back in this economy?
No, the reopening stocks have had huge rallies off the lows. And so they're up a lot and they're overbought. And I think that's where you're going to get the pullback. But the reality is they're still down a lot from where they were in February. So I think you're going to shake out some of the weak holders. The market will pull back. I think positioning has been too negative, and this will create an opportunity, especially the professional managers, to get a little bit more aggressively position these value stocks, and that will ultimately put a floor in the pullback. That's exactly what happened in 09. You go back to 09, the market rallied straight from March until June. You had a pullback in June through July, and it gave people an opportunity to position in the things that worked off the low. It's classic post-recessionary script, I think we're seeing.
Sure. No, there's definitely similar rhythms there. Lee, I wonder if you're an investor who, let's say, was not right there when the market bottomed with an aggressive exposure to stocks, and maybe you started to warm up to the idea later on in this rally. Now you see this pullback. Where do you think the smart move is in terms of reallocation at this stage?
Yeah, I think if you're looking at it from a long-term perspective, now might be a good time to go and scoop up some of those quality stocks that have great potential when you look at it through a long-term lens. We don't work with our clients on short-term trends, but I like the idea of perhaps picking up a Delta at $22 a share. If you think that at some point we'll go back to flying in airplanes again and you've got a long enough time horizon, I think it's a great value.
Did you rethink that when someone like Warren Buffett sold out of his airline positions, who's the ultimate long-term thinker, Lee?
I didn't really rethink it. I wondered candidly, like a lot of people. I mean, I think it was in February, and at that point he owned upwards of 12% of Delta and 10% of a lot of other airlines. It made me question it, but in his particular instance, if he just bought Delta at 65 and watched it drop down below that, perhaps it, with his portfolio, is an opportunity to do some harvesting of losses against other gains. Warren Buffett's in a very different position than, dare I say, any of us. So it made me wonder, but if he thought it was enough of a value at 40, and again, with the thesis that, hey, listen, things are going to pan out long term, it did make me question it. And candidly, I bought more of it myself.
Andrew, what do you think about the airlines? And it's an interesting group to focus on because it really has been the sort of litmus test of this market of how investors are feeling on a given day about the reopening and about the economic recovery. I mean, it used to be dollar yen. Now it's the airlines. If they're sharply down pre-market, it's going to be a down day. Are you buying?
Sure. No, I mean, I think that's a great point. And I think that or the cruise industry is a great analogy, which is, you know, on the one hand, the stocks are up, you know, double or triple off the low. And that seems insane that they've come back this quickly. And so people that are cautious are looking, saying, boy, this is way too much, too fast. On the other hand, the stocks are still could be, if we got back to where they were in February, they would be up, you know, 100, 200% from these levels. So it depends where your time frame is. I think Lee's exactly right. If your time frame is looking out a year or two, they could be up a lot. But if your time frame is today, you're going, boy, I think this is crazy that